of good words. I don't know of many fools that stand in better place, hardest like him. Before Trixie wanted to defy the matter. Not sure it's not, Jessica. Now be sweet, say thy opinion. How dost thou like the Lord Bassanio's wife?
Past all expressing. It was very meet the Lord Bassanio live an upright life. Having such a blessing in his lady, he finds the joys of heaven here on earth. If on earth he did not merit it, in reason he should never come to heaven.
Even such a husband hast thou of me as she is for a wife.
Nay, that's my opinion to of that.
I will them none. First let us go to dinner.
Nay, let me praise you while I have the stomach.
No, pray thee. Serve for table talk. And howsoever thou speakest, among other things, I shall digest it.
Well.
Antonio here.
Ready, so please your grace.
I am sorry for thee. Thou art come to answer a stony adversary, an inhuman wretch, incapable of pity, void and empty from any dram of mercy.
I've heard your grace hath taken great pains to qualify his rigorous course. Since he stands obdurate, I oppose my patience to his fury, and am armed to suffer with the quietness of spirit, the very tyranny and rage of his.
Go on, call the Jew into the court.
He's ready at the door. He comes, my lord.
Thank you! Let him stand before our face. Pity on his horses that have of late so huddled on his back, enough to press a royal merchant down, and pluck commiseration of his state from brassy bosoms and rough hearts of flint, from stubborn Turks and Tartars, never trained officers of tender courtesy. We all expect a gentle answer.
I have possessed your grace about thy purpose, and by our holy Sabbath have I sworn to have the due and forfeit of my bond. If you deny it, let the danger light on your charter and your city's freedom. You'll ask me why I rather choose to have a weight of carrion flesh than to receive 3,000 dagers. I'll not answer that, but say it is my humor. Is it answered? Part of my house be troubled with a rat, and I be pleased to give 10,000 ducats to have it paid. What? Are you answered yet? Some men there are love not the gaping pig. Some that are mad when they behold a kit, and some that when the bagpipe sings in the nose cannot contain a urine. For affection, master of passion, sways to that mood which it lacks, O lords. Now, for your answer, as there is no firm reason to be rendered why he cannot abide a gaping pig, why he, a harmless
necessary, kid.
Where he, a woman bagpipe, but of force, must yield to such inevitable shame as to offend. Himself being offended. So can I give no reason, nor I will know. More than a launched hate and a certain loathing I bear Antonio, that I follow thus a losing suit against him. Are you answered?
This is no answer, thou unfeeling man, to excuse the courage of thy cruelty.
I am not bound to please thee with my answers.
Do all men kill the things they do not love?
Hates any man the thing he would not kill?
Every offense is not hate at first.
Prince out of the serpent's finger twice.
I pray you think you question with the Jew? You may as well go stand up on the beach and bid the main flood bait his usual height. You may as well use question with the wolf, why he hath made the ewe bleat for the lamb. You may as well forbid the mountain pines to wag their high tops and to make no noise when they are threatened with the gusts of heaven. You may as well do anything most hard as seek to soften that than which what's harder. This Jewish heart? Therefore I beseech you, make no more offers, use no farther means, but with all brief and plain conveniency, let me have judgment and the Jew his will.
For thy 3,000 ducats, here is 6.
If every battle in 6,000 ducats were in 6 parts, and every part a ducat, I would not draw them. I would have my bomb.
How canst thou hope for mercy, rendering none?
What judgment shall I dread, doing no wrong? You have among you many a purchased slave, which like your asses and your dogs and mules, you use in abject and in slavish parts, because you bought them. Shall I say to you, let them be free? Marry them to your heirs. Why set they under burdens? Let their beds be made as soft as yours, and their parts seasoned with such viands. You will answer, the slaves are ours. So do I answer you. Upon the flesh that I demand of him is dearly born. Is mine, and I will have it. If you deny me, fie upon your law. There is no force in the decrees of Venice. I stand for judgment. Answer, shall I have it?
Upon my power, I may dismiss this court. Unless Bellario, a learned doctor whom I have sent for to determine this, come here today.
My lord, here stays without a messenger with letters from the doctor. You come from Padua.
Bring the letters. Call the messenger.
Good cheer, Antonio. What, man, courage yet? The Jew shall have my flesh, blood, bones, and all, ere thou shalt lose from me one drop of blood.
I am a tainted weather of the flock, meetest for death. The weakest kind of fruit drops earliest to the ground. So let me. You cannot be better employed, Bassanio, than to live still and write my epitaph.
Come you from Padua, from Bellario?
Both, my lord. Bellario greets your grace.
Why dost thou whet my knife so earnestly?
To cut the forfeiture from that bankrupt there.
Can no bird pierce thee?
No, none that thou hast wit enough to make. I'll be thou damned inexorable dog! And for thy life, let justice be accused. Thou almost makes me waver in my faith to hold opinion with Pythagoras, that animals infuse themselves into the drunks of men, for their desires are wolfish, bloody, starved, and ravenous.
Till thou canst drain the seal from off my bond, thou but offends thy lungs to speak so loud. Repair thy wit, good youth, or it will fall to cureless ruin. I stand here for law.
This letter from Bellario doth commend a young and learned doctor to our court. Where is he?
He attendeth here hard by to know your answer, or whether you'll admit it.
With all my heart. Go, give him courteous conduct to this place. In the meantime, the court shall hear Valario's letter. Your Grace shall understand that at the receipt of your letter I am very sick, but in the instant that your messenger came, in loving visitation with me was a young doctor of Rome. His name is Balthazar. I acquainted him with the cause and controversy between the Jew and Antonio the merchant. We turned over many books together. He is furnished with my opinion, which, bettered with his own learning, the greatness whereof I cannot enough commend, comes with him, at my importunity, to fill up your grace's request in my stead. You hear the learned Bellario what he writes. And this, I take it, is the doctor? Give me your hand. Come you from old Bellario?
I did, my lord.
You are welcome. Take your place. Are you acquainted with the difference that keeps this present question in the court?
I'm informed thoroughly of the cause. Which is the merchant here and which the Jew?
Antonio and old Sherlock, both stand forth.
Is your name Sherlock?
Sherlock is my name.
A strange nature is the suit you follow. Yet in such rule that the Venetian law cannot impugn you as you do proceed. You stand within his danger, do you not?
Aye, so he says.
Do you confess the bond?
Do.
Then must the Jew be merciful.
On what compulsion must I? Tell me that.
The quality of mercy is not strained. It droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It is twice blessed. It blesseth him that gives and him that takes. 'Tis mightiest in the mightiest. It becomes the throned monarch better than his crown. His scepter shows the force of temporal power, the attribute to awe and majesty wherein doth sit the dread and fear of kings. But mercy is above this scepter's sway. It is enthroned in the hearts of kings. It is an attribute to God himself. And earthly power doth then show lightest gods when mercy seasons justice. Therefore, Jew, though justice be thy plea, consider this, that in the course of justice, none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy, and that same prayer doth teach us all to render the deeds of mercy. I spoke thus much to mitigate the justice of thy plea, which if thou follow, the strict court of Venice must needs give sentence against the merchant here.
My deeds upon my head. I crave the law, the penalty and forfeit of my bond.
Is he not able to discharge the money?
Yes! Here I tender it for him in the court, yea, twice a sum. If that will not suffice, I will be bound to pay it 10 times more on forfeit of my hands, my head, my heart! If this will not suffice, then it must appear that malice bears down truth!
And the ball.
I have an oath in heaven. Shall I lay perjury upon my soul? No. Not for Venice.
And this bond is forfeit. Lawfully by this, the Jew may claim a pound of flesh to be by him cut off nearest the merchant's heart. Be merciful. Take thrice thy money, bid me tear the bond.
When it is paid, according to the tenor, it doth appear you are a worthy judge. You know the law. Your exposition hath been most sound. I charge by the law, whereof you are a well-deserving pillar, proceed to judgment. By my soul, I swear, there is no power in the tongue of man to alter me. I stay here on my bond.
Most heartily, I do beseech the court to give the judgment.
And thus it is. You must prepare your bosom for his knife.
Oh, excellent judge. Oh, wise young man.
For the intent and purpose of the law have full relation to the penalty.
Tis very
here true. Appeareth due upon the bond.
Oh, wise and upright judge. How much more elder art thou than thy looks?
Therefore lay bare your bosom.
Aye, his breast. So says the bond. Doth it not, most noble judge? Nearest to his heart! Those are the very words.
It is so. Are there balance here to weigh flesh?
I have them ready.
Have by some surgeon, Shylock, on your charge, to stop his wounds, lest he do bleed to death.
Is it so nominated in the bond?
It is not so expressed, but what of that? Twere good you do so much for charity.
I cannot find it. Tis not in the bond.
You, merchant, have you anything to say?
Little. I am armed. Well prepared. Bassanio, give me your hand. Fare you well. Grieve not that I am fallen to this for you. Commend me to your honorable wife. Tell her the process of Antonio's end. Say how I loved you. Speak me fair in death. And when the tale is told, bid her be judge whether Bassanio had not once. Pays your debt. For if the Jew do cut but deep enough, I'll pay it instantly with all my heart.
Antonio, I am married unto a wife which is as dear to me as life itself. But life itself, my wife, all the world are not with me esteemed above thy life. I would give all. I sacrifice them all to this devil here to deliver you.
Your wife would give you little thanks for that if she were by to hear you make the offer.
I have a wife who I protest I love. I wish she were in heaven so she could entreat some power to change this Courage, Jew!
It's well you offer it behind her back.
These be the Christian husbands. I have a daughter. Would any of the stock of Barabbas have been her husband?
Rather than a Christian! We pray for time! I pray you pass your sentence!
How of that same merchant's flesh is thine?
God awards it. The Lord hath given.
Most learned judge.
And you must take this flesh from off his breast.
The law allows it, and the court awards it.
Most delightful judge. A sentence. Home, prepare!
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Thou shalt see the difference of our spirits. I pardon thee thy life before thou ask it. For half thy wealth, it is Antonio's. The other half comes unto the general state, which humbleness may drive unto a fine.
I for the state, not for Antonio.
Nay, take my life in all. Pardon not that. You take my house, when you do take the prop that does sustain my house. You take my life, when you take the means whereby I live.
What mercy can you render him, Antonio?
A halter gratis, nothing else for God's sake.
So please, my lord the Duke, and all the court, to quit the fine for one half of his goods, and content. So he will let me have the other half in use, to render it upon his death, unto the gentleman that lately stole his daughter. Two things provided more. That for this favor, he presently become a Christian.
Shall do this, or else I do recant the pardon I late pronounced it here.
Art thou contented, Jew? What dost thou say?
I am content.
Clerk, draw thee the gift.
Pray you, give me leave to go from hence. I am not well. Send the deed after me. And I will sign it.
Get thee gone. But do it.
In christening shalt thou have two godfathers. Had I been judge, thou shouldest have had 10 more to bring me to the gallows, not the font. Invite you home with me to dinner.
I humbly do desire your grace of pardon. I must await this night to our Padua, and his meat I presently set forth.
I am sorry your leisure serves you not. Antonio, gratify this gentleman, for in my mind you are much bound with
him. Most worthy gentleman, I and my friend have by your wisdom been this day acquitted of grievous penalties.
In lieu whereof, 3,000 ducats due unto the Jew, we freely cook your courteous pains withal.
And stand indebted over and above in love and service to you evermore.
He is well paid that is well satisfied, and I, delivering you, am satisfied. I pray you, know me when we meet again. I wish you well, and so take my leave.
Dear sir, of course, I must attend you further. Take some remembrance from us as tribute, not as a fee. Grant me two things, I pray you. Not to deny me, and to pardon me.
You press me far, and therefore I will yield. And for your love, I'll take this ring from you. Do not draw back your hand. I'll take no more, and you, in love, will not deny me this.
This ring, good sir? Alas, it's a trifle. I would not shame myself to give you this.
I will take nothing else but only that. Now make things I have a mind to it.
There's more depends on this than on the value. The dearest ring in Venice will I give you, and find it out my proclamation. Only for this, I pray you pardon me.
I see, sir, you are liberal with offers. You taught me first to beg. Now methinks you teach me how a beggar should be answered.
Good sir, this ring was given me by my wife. When she put it on, she made me vow that I should never sell, or give, or lose it.
That skill serves many men to save their gifts. And if your wife be not a mad woman, and know how well I have deserved this ring, she would not hold out enemy forever for giving it to me. Well, peace be with you.
My Lord Bassanio, let him have the ring. Let his deservings and my love withal be valued against your wife's commandment.
Go, Graziano. Run it over to him. Give him the ring. Bring him, if thou canst, unto Antonio's house. Away! Make haste! Come. You and I will thither presently. And in the morning early, we will both fly towards the Belmont. Come, Antonio.
Inquire the Jew's house out. Give him this deed and let him sign it. We'll await tonight.
Fair sir! My Lord Bassanio, by your advice, I give you here this ring and entreat you to dinner.
That cannot be. His ring I do accept most thankfully, and so I pray you tell him. Furthermore, I pray you show my youth your old Shylock's house.
That will I do.
Sir, I would speak with you. I'll see if I can get my husband's ring, which I did make him swear to keep forever. Amazed, I warrant. We'll have old swearings that they did give away the rings to men, but we'll outface them and outswear them too. In haste, away, thou knowest where I will tarry. Come, good sir, will you show me to this house?
Is thick inlaid with patterns of bright gold. There's not the smallest orb which thou beholdest, but in his motions, like an angel saying, still inquiring in the young-eyed cherub. Such harmonies in immortal souls.
whilst this muddy vesture of decay is grossly frozen in. I cannot hear it.
I never marry when I hear sweet music.
Mark the music.
The light we see is burning in my hall. How far that little candle throws its beams. So shines a good deed in a naughty world. When the moon shone, we did not see the candle, so that the greater glory dimmed the less. A substitute shines brightly as a king until a king be by. And then his state empties itself as doth an inland brook into the main of waters. Music, hark. It is your music, madam, of the house. Nothing is good, I see, without respect. Thinks it sounds much sweeter than by day. Silence bestows that virtue on it, madam. The crow doth sing as sweetly as the lark when neither is attended. And I think the nightingale, if she should sing by day when every goose is cackling, would be thought no better a musician than the wren. How many things by seasoned are to their right praise and true perfection.
That is the voice where I much deceived of Portia.
He knows me as the blind man knows the cuckoo by a bad voice.
Dear lady, welcome home.
We have been praying for our husband's welfare, which speed we hope the better for our words. Are they returned?
Madam, they are not yet. But there's come a messenger before to signify their coming.
Go in, Nerissa. Order to my servants that they take no note at all of our being absent hence. Nor you, Lorenzo. Jessica, nor you.
Your husband is at hand, I hear his trumpet. There are no telltales, madam, fear you not.
You are welcome home, my lord.
Thank you, madam. You're welcome to my friend. This is the man. This is Antonio, to whom I am so infinitely bound.
You should in all sense be much bound to him. For as I hear, he was much bound for you.
No more than I am well acquitted of.
Sir, you are very welcome to our house. It must appear in other ways than words, therefore I stand to this room
first. Hey, Dr. Moon, I swear you knew me wrong. In faith, I gave it to the judge's clerk. Would he were gelt that had it for my part, since you do take it, love, so much in heart.
A quarrel, though, already. What's the matter?
About a hoop of gold, a paltry ring she did give me, who suppose he was for all the world a cutler's poetry upon a knife. Love me and leave me not.
What talk you of the posy or the value? You swore to me when I had given you that you would wear it till your hour of death. Though not for me, and for your given oaths, you should have been respected and have kept it. Even a judge's clerk. No gods, my judge's clerk will never have his face that had it.
He will, and if he lived to be a man.
Aye, a woman lived to be a man.
Now by this hand I gave it to a youth. A kind of boy, a little scrubbing boy. The judge's clerk that begged it as a fee, a prating boy. I cannot for my heart deny him.
You were to blame, I must be plain with you, to part so slightly with your wife's first gift. A thing stuck on with oaths upon your finger, and so riveted with faith unto your flesh. I gave my love a ring, and made him swear never to part with it. And here he stands. I dare be sworn for him, he not leave it nor pluck it from his finger for the wealth of world masters. Now, in faith, Graziano, you give your wife to unkind a cause for grief. And twere to me, I should be mad at it.
Why, I were best to cut my left hand off and swear I lost the ring defending it.
My lord Bassanio gave his ring away to the judge and asked it, and indeed deserved it too.
What ring gave you, my lord? Not that I hope that you received of me.
If I could add a lie unto a fault, I would deny it. But you see, my finger hath not the ring upon it. It is gone.
Even so, void is your false heart of truth. By heaven, I'll ne'er come in your bed until I see that ring.
Nor I in yours till I again see mine.
Sweet Portia, if you did know to whom I gave the ring, if you did know for whom I gave the ring, or would conceive for what I gave the ring, and how unwillingly I left the ring when naught would be accepted but the ring, you would abate the strength of your displeasure.
If you had known the virtue of the ring, or half her worthiness that gave the ring, or your own honor to contain the ring, you would not let it part.
me what to believe. Mm. I'll die for it, but some woman had the ring.
No. By my honor, madam, by my soul, no woman had it, but a civil doctor which did refuse 3,000 ducats of me and begged the ring, which I did deny him and suffered him to go displeased away. Even he that did uphold the very life of my dear friend. What should I say, sweet lady? My honor would not let ingratitude so much besmear it. Pardon the fault, dear lady.
Let not that doctor e'er come near my house. Mm. I'll not deny him anything I have. No, not my body nor my husband's bed. Know him I shall, I'm well sure of it. By not a night from home, watch me like Argus. If you do not, if I be left alone, now by mine honor, which is yet mine honor, I'll have that doctor for my bedfellow. And I am the doctor's clerk, so be well advised how you do leave me to mine own protection.
Well, do you so? Let not me take him then, for if I do, I'll mar the young clerk's pen.
I am the unhappy subject of these quarrels.
Sir, grieve not you. You are welcome, notwithstanding.
Portia, forgive me this enforced wrong. And in the hearing of these many friends, I swear to thee, pardon this fault, and by my soul, I swear, I never more will break an oath with thee.
Once to defend my body for his wealth, which but for him that had your husband's ring, had quite miscarried. I dare be bound again, my soul upon the forfeit, that your lord nevermore will break faith advisedly.
Then you shall be his short. Give him this, and bid him keep it better than the other.
Here, Lord Bassanio. Swear to keep this ring.
By heaven, it is the same I gave the doctor.
I had it of him. Oh, pardon me, Bassanio, for by this ring the doctor lay with me. And pardon me, my gentle Roxana, for that same scrubbing boy, the doctor's clerk. In lieu of this, last night did lie with me.
Why, this is like